The way ECOMP came about was, if that's what was happening in the industry, network virtualization, turning physical devices into applications, exploiting the cloud technology that gives me all this dynamic control, what led to ECOMP was when we had asked the question, okay, if that's what our networks are going to look like, what type of management and monitoring do we need to support that? If I can move network elements around dynamically, automatically give them more or less resources, I need a management capability, a management platform that can deal with those more dynamic things. So I need to be able to instantiate applications, now network elements, dynamically, monitor them as soon as I instantiate them, configure them for the services customers want. And this led to all of the technical drivers that led us to develop ECOMP. It has the functions it has the architecture that it has due to these drivers, having to meet this more dynamic set of requirements for service creation, deployment, and management.
What was new to my team, at least, was the scale of this project and the coordination. We're trying to build something that basically creates new services for AT&T customers, deploys them, and operates them. That's huge, and there's never been a system this big that we've I don't know, in the industry, but certainly not with anything we've tried. And that being part of the much broader team, whilst trying to create something that's so cutting edge, moving at incredible speed, that was a challenge and something we all had to learn how best to do, and I think something we got the hang of.
From the point of view of when we started the design and the architecture way back, one of the challenges was we were really looking at really many segments of the business and many segments of systems. In other words, we have systems today that do certain things. ECOMP really encompasses many of those functions in the platform. So we were going from, how do I allow service designers the ability to come in and create a service, to how do I then take the data that describes that service, distribute it to an execution platform, which when asked to configure and instantiate that service will use that data, as well as data in the customer request, to do the configuration and then the ongoing management of that service. That's a soup to nuts set of requirements. It says, how do I allow, at design time, service designers to create a new service, like an MPLS network or a voice over IP network? How do I then take that definition, create an execution platform that can ingest that definition, understand what the customer has just requested, and then create, instantiate that service, deploy it, and manage it, all under program control? So we were talking about really all aspects of a service from its initial creation to instantiation, configuration, and management. And the platform had to provide all of those capabilities. So the challenge for us was, how do we do this in a coherent way? Jen mentioned we have a number of components in ECOMP. We created those components doing all of these functions. They have to work together. So defining the interfaces between them, the flows that have to go on between them to achieve all those functions, was a major challenge. This is probably one of the largest software projects we've worked on in years. People were that excited because they knew what the implications were for the company and the industry. And so they were just, you know, energized to really get it done. To me, we're on the cusp of a what's next in terms of, we made the decision to open source the ECOMP code in the fall of last year. And I mean, if you look at what that meant, we created a platform that arguably is one of the most comprehensive and more advanced than anything else the industry had. And we gave it away. We put it out in the industry that said, we're making this available for all service providers, all vendors, all integrators, to download that code and use it the same way AT&T would make use of it. And that was a big deal.
So I've had experiences like when I've been out at conferences or industry forums where people would come up and, you know, they've heard about ECOMP or heard about us talking about it, and they'll come up and they'll say, so is any of this real? Have you prototyped any of it? Have you explored it, tried it in a lab or something? And it's really amazing to watch their response when you say, no, this is operational in AT&T's network. This is real. This isn't an idea, just an idea. This isn't a prototype. This is real and working in AT&T's network. There's still things we've got to do. There's still a way to go on it, but it is something that is operational, and that just floors people when you sit there and take that. It's also been interesting watching the feedback on the ONAP distribution lists and things like that. So we've had feedback at least on some of the components like policy, where they'd sit and say, you know, we had this concept, we, you know, this is aligned with the kind of thinking we've got, but you've got it real. And I think that's a real differentiator. We're not just thinking, we have it.